action.
Whoa! Now that's big.
12 inches. That is regulation, baby.
Cut! Who is this idiot? You! You! Why are you in my space? Why?
What is all this crap? Aliens, hey, baby, fishing poles! Who's ever seen a shark that big? All this stuff's gotta go. Why'd you get in this business, you prick? Huh? For the pussy. That's why. What is this?
This is my art. Security!
Look, you pompous asshole. I own you now. I own all of this. We're gonna turn this place around. I'm gonna make you rich.
You're Tommy Vercetti, but I thought that you were...
That's right. We're gonna be making some changes around here and start making some real money.
Actually, have you ever thought about,
But first, we're gonna need some good-looking bras.
Yeah, girls are fine, but you... Wow.
What's that guy think this is? Some free art crap? Jeez, like anyone ever watched movies about fish?
You can't have shit around here, man!
Yo, Candy, I'm looking for movie talent. You interested?
Sure. But you'd have to
talk
to my agent.
There's nothing my money's gonna buy.
The hell are you doing?
You should have stayed at home today.
Can you believe this, asshole?
Mercedes.
Hey, Tommy. You want a party?
Not now, sweet. You interested in doing some movies?
Of course, as long as it's cheap and sleazy.
You're hired. Get in.
Don't you love this new single?
Where are you going?
Love and having high.
had 30 passionate encounters with the secretaries.
Tommy, when are we going to spend some time alone? Tommy, you coming in for a warm-up?
Maybe later, babe.
Whoa! Cool shark.
How's filming going, Steve?
Well, Candy is a natural. And that new girl, she's insatiable. She went through half the cast and crew before I even took a light reading. Anyway, hey, tomorrow we're going on location to shoot the boat scenes.
Boat scenes? What boat scenes?
The fishermen are in the throes of passion when the giant shark comes in.
What'd I say about the giant shark? I said, no giant shark, all right? Just keep the cameras pointed at the poontang.
Okay. Hey, Tommy, you guys got to try, right?
You get those flyers printed up?
Yeah, but nobody's going to let us distribute those things. I mean, they're just too, they're unimaginative.
You don't worry about that. I've got my own ideas for distribution.
Okay. Hey, Candy, in my trailer.
Okay, what's the problem now?
After his close encounter with the Nympho invaders, our hero finds himself unable to think of anything but this huge phallic mountain. And that's when I want to do the scene with the vat of mashed potatoes, but then
I don't give a crap about that! Just keep going, keep going. You mentioned something about some legal problem on the phone.
Congressman Alex Shrub has jumped on the pre-election bandwagon. He's going after the Puritan vote. Rumors are he's going to support measures to restrict, shall we say, the more fleshy aspects of this nation's great entertainment industry.
Okay, all right. Okay.
Candy, okay, you know Shrub. Okay, you guys get up to anything kinky?
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Uh-huh.
Oh, yeah.
All right.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. All right.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, Candy. Oh. Yeah.
Oh. Yeah. Oh. Yeah. Got that.
Was that part of the, or was she talking to?
Hey, I can never tell. Anyway, you're probably best following her after the shoot. See if she'll lead you to their new love nest.
You got a camera?
Yeah, get him a camera.
Sometimes life throws you a curveball. We help our blue chip clients get their lives back after circumstances have conspired against them. Just listen.
It was an unfortunate accident what happened to my wife on that precarious cliff. The layer with Furex can't bring my wife back, but they made sure I didn't end up in the slammer.
I was unfortunate enough to be found with 15 kilos in my spare tire. I was so mad at the auto repair shop that sold me that tire. Thanks to DeLeon Furex, the district attorney saw it that way too.
I accidentally torched a Quickie Mart when my medication ran out. DeLeon Furex helped me and the community by
Hey!
Company.
At DeLeon Furex, we understand that...
Ken, could you call me Martha?
Oh, Alex. I mean Martha. Whatever you say.
Today at 866-974-2333. That's 866-9-SHAPE. DeLeon and Furex. Accidents happen, and we'll prove it.
Martha, someone's watching. How kinky.
You, give me that camera.
Sorry, but I just can't swallow
this right now. Come on, darling. He's hung like a sperm whale, for pity's sake. How can you not feel the part?
But Stevie...
How's my star director?
Oh, man, the struggle between the artistic integrity and the humping, pumping action continues unabated. And before you ask, yes, all four videos will be released by their... Honey, can you please keep the Andacon in the shot? He costs more per hour than you do.
Oh, sorry, Steve.
I was thinking, we need some kind of big stunt to really promote the launch. Something that will make a real impact on this city. You got any ideas?
Well, in the old days, they used to have gala events, stars, limos, the night sky crisscrossed with searchlights.
Searchlights. I got an idea.
Yeah. Well, little sequin numbers and the limos. Premieres. Oh, yes, ma'am. Of course, ma'am. And the press and the barrage of lights.
I called myself Mario.
In my wonderful book, I tell of the...
You're a walking
crashing you, baby.
Girls are out.
Thank you.
cachet.
Rusty Brown's ring.
Make sure you enjoy Rusty.
It's just the boy next door.
Hello there, Danny. You know it was hockey season.
Deadly curse, a deranged killer, a small town in tears. Knife After Dark, rated R for retarded.
What do you want, Paul? I don't want any fake label clothes.
Very funny, mate, but you know I don't touch bent gear. No, I was just calling to see if I could get a part in one of your movies. Back in England, I did a lot of blue stuff, mate. I'm packing more heat than you, my son.
Paul, thanks for the offer. I'll bear that in mind.
Seriously, don't forget about me after all I've done for you.
That's what I'm trying to forget about.
What's going on?
Tommy! Oh, good. Listen. I like fish. I love fish. I love them as pets in bowls, or as food on a plate, but as much as I love them, I don't want to sleep with them, okay? But right now, your Italian brothers are coming from up there to fit me with some cement shoes, and I...
Shut up, Ken! Sit down.
Lance, what the hell's going on?
It's your friends up north, Tommy. They ain't too happy you capped their man. They're coming down to see the business today.
They took longer than I thought. Guys, we gotta make this final. We gotta leave no doubt that this is my operation. Mine! Ken, you get the first run of counterfeit cash and put 20 mil in briefcases. Lance, you get the guys together.
Tommy! What? No big hugs for your old buddy?
I've had 15 years out of the loop. I'm a bit rusty on family etiquette.
Oh, he's angry, huh, Tommy? Didn't I say your temper would get you into trouble, huh?
There's 3 mil in the cases.
How many was it? 10? No, 11 men. That's how you get to be called the Howard Butcher.
You sent me to kill one man. One man! They knew
hey, Tommy,
I was coming, sonny.
Tommy! Watch your tone. Anyone would think you blame me for that unfortunate set of circumstances.
Just take the money.
Get the damn cash. You know, Tommy, I did what I could for you. I pulled strings, called in favors. I was your friend, Tommy. I hoped you'd see sense, see what's good for business. I trusted you, Tommy, and you disappointed me. But at least someone in your chicken shit organization knows how to do business. Isn't that right, Lance?
Sorry, Tommy. This is Vice City. This is business.
You sold us out.
No, I sold you out, Tommy. I sold you out! The real cash is upstairs in the safe.
So, Tommy, what was the big plan? You think I'd just take the fake cash, save face, and run away with my tail between my legs?
No. I just wanted to piss you off before I kill you.
One to cover your ass now, eh, Tommy?
You're going down, you backstabbing prick.
Oh, you think so? You wanted this! Double-crossing piece of shit! Your history, Tommy! History!
Dance for Lance Vance. You took 15 years from me, Sonny, and now I'm gonna make you pay!
You still don't get it, do you? I own you, Tommy! Those 15 years were mine to spend. Get him, boys. He never understood a thing.
Come on, then, asshole.
Tommy? Oh my God, Tommy, what happened?
What does it look like?
It looks like you ruined your suit, and Tommy, that was a beautiful suit. Tommy, what on earth happened?
Had a disagreement with a business associate. You know how it is.
Tommy, I have a disagreement. I send them an angry letter. Maybe I pee in their mailbox. I don't start World War III. You know, maybe you should speak to my shrink.
That stupid prick, Lance.
Tommy, I never liked that guy, okay? He's neurotic, he's insecure, he's self-centered. The guy's an asshole. I'm glad you took him out.
I don't think we're gonna be getting any more heat from up north either. Because there ain't no up north anymore. It's all down south now.
Wait, does that mean what I think it means? Tommy, baby!
What do you think it means?
That we're in charge. I mean, that you're in charge. Oh, Tommy!
You know, Ken, I think this could be the beginning of a beautiful business relationship. After all, you're a conniving, backstabbing, two-bit thief, and I'm a convicted psychotic killer and drug dealer.
I know. Ain't it just beautiful?
Thank you.
Tommy, it's Paolo. How are you? Right, mate. Anyway, thought I had to drop you a line. Oh, my good lord, my son. You will not believe the quality of the brass I just encountered. Streetwalker or something, just down in Little Havana, mate. Said her name was Mercedes or something. Oh, my God, mate. You've got to check this bird out. Could strip the lead out of a pencil. Said I was the best you ever had and all. Keep your potato skin fluffy, seeing ya.
Tommy, Tomas, it's Cortez. ¿Qué pasa?
Things are interesting. How are you, my friend?
I wanted to ask you about Mercedes.
Okay. What about her?
Oh, Tommy, I hear these stories, all these stories. I don't know what to think. Maybe she thinks she could do what she likes. But, Tommy, tell me, is it true?
Is what true?
The stories I hear. She really going to be a lawyer. Tommy, the shame. The shame. You know, we Cortez are a proud family. We would never allow a daughter of ours to become a lawyer. Please tell me it isn't so. I don't think I could take it.
Oh, Colonel, I can assure you, Mercedes is never going to become a lawyer. Don't worry about it.
Oh, thank you, Tommy. Tommy, thank you. The shame would be unbearable. Anyway, Tommy, you must excuse me, all right? The new Minister of Interior has arrived. Many years ago, I killed his father in a failed coup, so I must be polite. Hey, good day, amigo.
Tommy, it's Ernest. Ernest Kelly.
Hey, how are you?
I'm doing okay. I'll need a stick to walk, but I should be back at work soon enough.
Good.
I heard about Lance. What a little prick, huh?
Yes.
Never trust a man who walks the streets in his pajamas, that's what I say. Glad you killed him. I hope it was painful for the prick.
I think it was. You know, I just didn't think he was like that.
Tommy, for a raging lunatic, you're pretty naive. I'll be back at work soon. Teach you a thing or two about life, you hear?
Take your time, Ernest. Look after yourself.
Tommy Fossetti. How's it going, Mr. Big Shot? I hear all these things about you. Some kind of plan in town now, eh?
Paul, you're drunk.
Nah, you stupid pal. I ain't drunk. I had a couple and some treats. I've been a bit of a couple of days, you know? Anyway, don't give me that. I ain't a mug. Who set you up in this town? Oh, me. That's who.
Really?
Don't give me that. Don't. I introduced you to people. I showed you the ropes. Did a lot of stuff for you, and this is how you repay me. You ignore me. You won't give me a way in, or after all I did for you. What do you think I am, a div or something?
Paul, take it easy. I've been busy. Don't be an idiot.
I ain't no idiot, Mush. That's what I said in Boston. You ask him the trouble, son, because you're going to get it. Tommy, mate, please. Use me, big O, please. Don't laugh at me.
Paul, get some sleep, seriously.
Tommy, it's Steve. You're a marvel. I'm a marvel. They love us. We are rewriting the record books, pal. We're talking major awards here. I can put my dad in a home and tell him to shut up. It's hot, man. Hot. H-O-T. He never believed in me. Never thought I was an artist. And now I've made it. I'm the best damn skin flick director of all time, my friend. And I just wanted to say, it's a pleasure to have met you. I love you, baby. Don't you go changing on me, you hear?